Okay, for this to work, we need to make sure that Wi-Fi is turned off in the Wario system. Otherwise, it will always get turned on automatically. First, you need to go to developer options. If you don't have developer options, please look it up on the internet how to enable it. And close to the end, you will see a setting, automatically enable Wi-Fi when charging. That should be turned off. Otherwise, every night when you charge your watch, it will get turned on again. And then under connectivity, you will be able to go to Wi-Fi and make sure to turn it off. If it's off, then using this Bluetooth bubble in Bubble Clouds, you will be able to toggle connectivity. So I can click on there, enable Bluetooth, and when Bluetooth is enabled, as the phone connects to the watch, you see now the little cloud icon behind the number 12 disappeared. If we go back here and disable Bluetooth, since Wi-Fi is also disabled, when we come here, we now see the closed cloud icon behind that number 12 there. The watch doesn't give out any radiation in this mode. Then on the phone, we will start Tasker from the Bubble Cloud. We are going to create a profile. So using the plus sign here, it's a time-based profile, and we're going to do it from 10:50 p.m. to 11:50 p.m. You will see why. This will put the watch in airplane mode at 10:50 p.m. And we're going to add a new task, which I'm going to call Bluetooth off. Okay, this new task will contain one command at the beginning, which is based on the plugin from Bubble Cloud. There are two kinds of Bubble Cloud plugins. We are going to do a Wear OS bubble. Use the pencil icon here to configure it. We can choose any bubble from the Bubble Cloud. So we can go and find this watch Bluetooth bubble, and we can just control that. We could turn it off, but if we turned it off, since there is no Bluetooth communication, Tasker would not be able to turn Bluetooth back on. So instead of just turning it off, we are going to turn it off until, let's say, turn it off until 6:30 in the morning. It uses the 24-hour clock, and notice there is a dot between hours and the minutes. That's basically all the setting we need. This is the setup. If you go back, you will see at 10:50 p.m., it's going to turn off Bluetooth, and in the little plugin, we controlled that it's going to be off until 6:30 in the morning. If this is enough for you, you can already hit the check mark there in the header and it's going to work. But we can improve it a little bit to make it moving sleep window. Instead of just setting a time, we can add another criteria to the profile, which is based on the power state of the phone. And we can say, if the power source, let's say you have a wireless charger for your phone at your bed, if you place your phone in the wireless charger between 10:50 p.m. and 11:50 p.m., and you can change that time to whatever you want, whenever you place your phone into that charger, it's going to turn off the Bluetooth on your watch at that point. And we can go even further, because this still has, you remember, the 6:30 wired into it. But that doesn't have to be that way. It can also be a time-based thing. So I'm going to create a Tasker variable this time, which is just going to be a variable set. We are going to set when Bluetooth should be turned back on. Call it Bluetooth on. And we are going to set it to a system variable, which is the time variable, and we do math and add 8 hours to it. and we just save this. Make sure we set this variable before calling the plugin. And then going back into the plugin configuration, we are going to change from the 630, press this little variable icon next to the field and choose the local tasker variable to supply the wake up time. So it works this way. Between 10:50 and 11:50, if I place my phone into the charger, it's going to turn off radiation from my watch and I can wear my watch for sleep tracking or whatever I want. I still keep adding exciting new functionality to this app. Anybody who upgraded to premium years ago still gets these additions for free. You can also support this fun project by simply liking this video or subscribing to my YouTube channel. My app could gain more exposure in the Play Store if more of you left 5-star ratings or upvoted other reviews there which you agree with. A lot of work has been put into this project. I just wish to get the app onto the wrists of as many Wear OS users as possible. Thank you for all your help in this. And as always, enjoy the bubble clouds.